So in this video, we'll study the lipids definition and classification of lipids. Now, lipids are heterogeneous group of organic compounds that are insoluble in water and soluble in non-polar organic solvents. So the lipids are insoluble in water. Now, this is one of the important character of a lipid molecule. They naturally occur in most plants, animals, microorganisms, and are used as cell membrane components, energy storage molecules, insulation, and hormones. Lipids may be either liquids or non-crystalline solids at room temperature. Now, lipids are found in plants. They are found in animals. They are found in microorganisms. As I told you, they are nothing but biological molecules which are associated with living things. And in the body of either plant or animal, they are found as cell membranes. So in the cell membrane, in the plasma membrane, you find the lipids. And in the body of plants and animals, you find lipid in the form of stored food material. Okay? And in some animals, you find lipid as an insulation material. For example, in the whale, you find blubber. Now, this blubber is nothing but lipid. The animals which live in cold environment, they have a fat layer below their skin, which acts like a insulation, which prevents the animals from extreme cold. Okay, so that is how it works, like a insulation. And hormones, the steroid hormones, they are of lipid in nature. They are lipid in nature, and they have some important functions, especially the functions which are associated with reproduction. And as per the property, the lipids may either exist in oil, I mean in liquid condition, or they may exist in solid condition. So we call them as oils and fats in the room temperature. Pure fats and oils are colorless, odorless, and tasteless. They are energy-rich organic molecules. So compared to the carbohydrates, lipid molecules are more energy-rich. So this is what we have to understand. The lipid molecules have more energy in them than the carbohydrate molecules. But the organisms, the cells prefer carbohydrates as a source of energy because it is easier to metabolize the carbohydrate molecules than the complex lipid molecules. But in many cases, especially in stress, in emergencies, under extreme conditions, lipid is going to be used as a source of energy. And the lipids are soluble in organic solvents like alcohol, chloroform, acetone, benzene, etc. They do not have any ionic charge, so neither they are not positively charged, negatively charged, etc. And solid triglycerols, which are commonly called fats, they have high proportions of saturated fatty acids, whereas the liquid triglycerols have high proportions of unsaturated fatty acids. So here in the lipid, we come across two kinds. One is commonly called fats, another one is commonly called oils. Now, what is the major difference between oils and fats? Now, oils are liquid in room temperature, and fats are solid at room temperature. And normally, we find oils in plants. Oils are produced from plant source, whereas fats are normally associated with animals. Now, what is the meaning of saturated and unsaturated? So, lipids are made up of fatty acids and glycerol. Okay. So, if you recall, carbohydrates are made up of monosaccharides. Protein molecules are made up of amino acids. In the same way, lipids are also made up of their own monomers. Here, lipid molecules are made up of fatty acids and glycerols. So fatty acids and glycerols constitute the basic units of lipids. Now the fatty acids may be either saturated or unsaturated. So what is saturated? Every possible bond is made with a hydrogen atom such that there exists no double bonds. That means if no double bonds are found in the fatty acid, such fatty acids are called saturated fatty acids. If a few or many double bonds are found in the fatty acid, then such fatty acids are called unsaturated fatty acids. Now let us move on to the classification of lipids. The first category is simple lipids. Now simple lipids, as the name suggests, these are the lipid molecules which yield fatty acids and glycerol upon hydrolysis. As I already mentioned, fatty acids and glycerols are the building blocks of lipid molecules. And the lipids which are made up of only fatty acids and glycerols can be considered as the simple lipids. Examples are fats, oils, and waxes. So as I already mentioned in a previous slide, fats are normally found associated with animals, whereas oils are normally associated with plants. So we consume, we use so many different kinds of oils which are produced from plant source, like sunflower oil, groundnut oil, castor oil, cotton seed oil, so like this, coconut oil. So all these are example for oils, whereas fat, the animal fat, the fat which is found in the animals, is an example for the simple lipid. The next type of example is waxes. So we are all familiar with wax. Now wax is also lipid in nature, and you know the waxes are produced by some animals. Even in our body, wax is produced. For example, in the inner ear, wax is produced, and its function is to trap the dust and prevent the entry of microorganisms and protect the inner ear from any infection, etc. So that is how wax is part of the animals. And one animal which is very famous for producing wax is honeybee. You know, honeybees construct their hives with this wax. So you can extract, you can collect wax from the honeybee hives. Then waxes are the compounds which yield fatty acids and long chain alcohols upon the hydrolysis. The next category of lipids is compound lipids. As the name suggests, here along with fatty acids and glycerol, we find different kinds of molecules associated with the lipid. Examples include phospholipids. So here phosphate group or phosphate molecule is associated with fatty acid and glycerol, and they yield fatty acids, glycerol, amino alcohol, sphingosine, phosphoric acid, and nitrogen containing alcohol upon hydrolysis. So main components are phosphate group and fatty acids and glycerol. Then they may be glycerophospholipids or sphingophospholipids depending upon the alcohol group present. If glycerol is present, then we call them as glycerophospholipids, and if sphingosine is present, sphingosine alcohol component is present, then they are called sphingophospholipids. Then we have the example of glycolipids. The name itself tells that the lipid molecule is associated with carbohydrates. So the association of carbohydrates and lipids results in the formation of glycolipids. They may also be glycerol-glycolipids or sphingoglycolipids depending upon the alcohol group present. Then the third category of protein lipids are derived lipids. So As in case of carbohydrate and proteins, here also derived lipids are the derivatives of the hydrolysis of some bigger lipid molecules. Hydrolysis product of simple and compound lipids are called derived lipids. Now they may include fatty acid, glycerol, sphingosine and steroid derivatives. Now here one of the very important example for derived lipids are steroid hormones, which play a vital role in many of the functions of the body. So that's about the definition and the classification of lipids.